Here we have PlanetPress Workflow, which is the automation tool that makes everything work together. In the first process, we'll be generating print output using the data mapping configuration and template we created in PlanetPress Connect. However, the very first step in the process must be the acquisition of data. If you recall, the data mapping configuration that we created uses line printer data or a text data source. This line printer data presumably comes from a legacy system which we have little control over. And this legacy system automatically sends line printer data only to a specific IP, which in this case will be PlanetPress Workflow. To capture this line printer data, we use an LPD input. In this task, all we need to set up is the queue name, which is equivalent to what the legacy system is sending to, because it's sending to an IP with a specific queue. This is what we need to put in. What we get out of the LPD input is exactly the line printer data that we're expecting in the data mapping configuration. So logically, our next step is to execute the data mapping using the task of the same name. In this task, the most important thing that we need to select is the appropriate data mapper configuration. So all I need to do is to select the data mapping configuration that we did in the first walkthrough. The output of the execute data mapping task is simply a record set containing a series of records. And the number of records corresponds to the number of source records in the incoming data sample. So what do we do with the record set? Well, the next step is to merge it to a document in order to produce output. Depending on the output we want to produce, so depending on the context that we want to execute, we'll be using one of three tasks: create email content, create print content, or create web content. Obviously, the one that we need to use here is the print. Now, again, the only thing that we really need to do here is to select the appropriate template. This is the one we sent using the package file. You can see on the right that we have a very nice preview indicating that this is the right file that we were expecting. The next step that we're adding is the create job. Now, currently, there's no properties per se for this task, but eventually we will have the ability to use job presets. We haven't touched on these because they're not actually supported in PlanetPress Workflow for now, but they do things like splitting and sorting and grouping your jobs together. And then we finish with create output. So once again, the create output, you'll need to select the preset that you want to use. And here we have the name of the preset as well as the destination, saying exactly where that output would be if we let the create output generate it. So the process is essentially complete. When we receive a line printer job, we're gonna execute the data mapping to get a record set, execute the create print content to get all of the content items, so all of our separate documents, create a job with them, and then generate the output in the format that we want. The reason I'm using PDF is that it is easier to see the output. So once this task runs, it's going to be sending the PDF file to the folder specified here, and you're going to be able to just double click on it and view it directly. Now, the last process that we'll be creating will actually send emails to all of the clients that wanted an email invoice instead of the printed one. We are going to create a trigger file, and when this trigger file is created, then the email process will run. So a very quick way to create a trigger file is to use the create file task. The information inside of the task doesn't really matter as long as there's some amount of text. And then we'll tell it to output directly to a specific folder, and that's where the other task will capture it. So now on to the last process that will output all of the emails. So as we mentioned, we'll be using a trigger file, and we'll be using the folder capture task to go and grab that trigger file when it exists. So this will only trigger the process. It doesn't actually give us any data. In order to get the data, we'll be using a Connect plugin again. So what I did here is that I have a data mapping configuration that is actually capturing data from a database. When you capture from a database, you don't actually need to give any of the information to the execute data mapping task. It will simply redo the database request and grab all the information that it needs, and then run the data mapping on that information. In the case of email output, there's only one other task that's really necessary, and that's the create email content. So here we select exactly the same document because the document has an email context, so it can be used for either processes. There is only one thing that we need to set up more inside of this task, and that's the email information. So here you need to put in a sender address and the mail host or the SMTP host for sending out emails. That's generally available from your IT department. Now, because we're sending the actual invoice, inside of our context, if you recall, the email context did not have all of the information for the invoice. It's simply the dynamic table, which gives you a kind of condensed view, and then we're telling the client that the invoice is attached to the email. All we need to do to do this is to click on Print Context as PDF Document. The actual output of the create email content is nothing that we actually need to use, so we'll just end this task with a delete. Now here's one last tip before we finish the walkthrough. When using the create email content, in the email info tab, there's an option called send emails to sender or test mode. By checking this option, all of the emails, instead of being sent to the email address set in the designer module, will be sent to the sender address. So this is it for the walkthrough on PlanetPress Workflow. And if you want more information on the product, simply visit the OL Learn website.